As a rideshare driver in the great city of Atlanta, Georgia, each day I engage in conversation with some truly awesome individuals. We talk about everything from politics and religion to relationships and family, as well as all points in between. Our conversations are open, enjoyable, and genuine. It has shown me that most people, no matter their walk of life, are overall the same. Since I love to drive and talk, and I'm also a filmmaker and a YouTuber, I decided to create a show that would merge all of those worlds together. Welcome to Get Lifted.
You have reached your destination.
All right. How you doing? I'm Derek.
I'm Indy. How you doing?
I'm good, Indy. So tell me something good, girl. What's going on with you today?
Nothing, just work and heading home.
What?
Yeah.
They ain't working too hard today, did they?
Nah.
Yeah.
No. The best thing is that it's another day at work.
Yeah.
Job.
There it is.
I disturbed somebody's spirit, and I'm okay with that.
You disturbed somebody's spirit today?
Yes.
Did they need it?
They did.
So, love. Okay. So, for clarification, when you say you disturbed somebody's spirit, I mean you had to cut somebody out?
No, I didn't have to cut somebody out. You know how you can treat somebody with a smile.
Oh, okay. All right.
The thing is, one of my coworkers, she don't like me, and I don't know what's her issue with me, and I don't care.
Okay.
Personally, it doesn't matter.
Right.
Well, she had a call for her, so I kept on calling her name. I said, hey, somebody calling, it's for you, it's for you. And she kept ignoring me. My other coworker heard me.
Okay.
And so I was like, okay, so she wanna ignore me, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
I'll notate the account, keep it moving.
Right, right.
And so when she finally got the reminder of the account that I was speaking of, she goes to tell my manager, she had an account for me and she's being rude.
Oh, no, come on.
And she being childish. I'm like, wait, you ignored me.
Right.
Three people hurt me. You choose to ignore me. And I'm being rude. Just like I told my manager, what you want me to do? Well, how you wanted me to have an account?
Right.
What you wanted me to do? The person wanted to speak to her. I don't know how she wanted this account to be worked.
Right.
So what you wanted me to do?
Right.
Sit and talk off your account? I can't talk off your account. Because if I talk it off wrong, then I'm wrong. And then I'm being petty. Then I'm being childish. You already don't like me for some type of reason in your head.
You're right.
So, Try to avoid the BS.
Well, you know, sometimes you just got to get a little BS on your shoe in order for you to get around it. Because sometimes you don't see it. You just be walking, and then you look back, you be like, God, dog, and I done stepped in some of this BS. But that's okay.
It's okay.
It ain't going to ruin my day.
It's not, because when she was upset and mad, I just smiled out. So what you going to do? How you going to do this? Pretty mad.
There you go.
I didn't do nothing to you.
There you go.
And I treat her with a smile. I smile to her every day. I keep it moving.
That's what is good, ain't it? When you can smile and they just be fuming.
Oh.
They be fired up. You just be like, hey.
Hey.
You know what? I did what I was supposed to do. You have a wonderful day.
God bless
her. There it is. So where you from?
Florida, Fort Lauderdale.
Fort Lauderdale?
Yes.
You from Florida, the Sunshine State? So I guess that means that you are not claiming peach status. So that makes you what? What's Florida? Oranges? And
yeah, oranges. And
you don't want to be no orange, though. Have you ever looked at an orange?
Well,
peaches are just
more
inviting.
Sunshine.
Can I get a little fist bump on the sunshine? Every time a sister get in here with me, in my brain, I'm like, swear to God, I don't know how old you are. You know, then they be talking in there and say, well, you know, my son, 37. I be like, God, your son almost old as me?
Yeah.
How is that possible?
Because we take good care of something.
Yes.
Something nice.
It does. Yep. That ain't no lie. It just shine when the sunlight hit it. You know? Got that radiance. You know what I mean?
Natural glow for no reason.
Yes.
I always say, God put an extra special magic on black women.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, you got to think about this. Just like if you go outside, why you wear dark colors? You don't want to wear dark colors in the sun because it absorbs heat. It absorbs that sunlight. You want to wear light colors because it reflects it. So if your skin, I ain't going to get into nothing. I ain't going to try to make it, you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to get into nothing, you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to sound all, anti. But when your skin is black and that sun absorbs, and your skin ain't that. With that reflective surface on. Glory.
Always popping.
Glory.
Yes. And I'm extra chocolate because I'm Jamaican in me, so I'm just so excited. I love my melanin.
I'm telling you. I wish I could put this shit in a bottle and sell it. No, I wouldn't. No, when all the wrong people be trying to buy it.
Somebody said, hold on, we gotta think about it too. White people do a little tan, trying to get this complexion. Maybe it's always imitated, but never duplicated.
Never duplicated.
Because we come in so many different shades. Oh, that's the most beautiful thing about us. We come in so many different shades.
I'm telling you.
We're resilient too. We're beautiful and resilient. A lot of things that would get other people down, we'd be like, you know what?
Keep it pushing.
But we all been without.
That's right. So it don't hurt so bad when you didn't experience it already.
This happened once upon a time ago.
That's right.
I know what my mom and grandma did. Let me go ahead and apply this pressure and do it a little different. 2019 to 20 ways.
That's right. It's the same story, different remedy. Same story, different remedy. You just got to do things a little bit different.
And you always got to do it. Keep your head first.
That's right.
Keep your foot first. And always be good to people.
That's right. Life. That's absolutely right.
Because you never know
who you're going to run into.
Because this world is so small.
That's right. That's right.
Well, thank you.
Miss Andy, thank you for being on my show.
No problem. Thank you for having me.
All right. Be looking out for yourself on there. You got to make sure you subscribe to that channel, my dear.
I was. Yeah. Who is Derek?
Andre TV. That's
okay,
it.
Hey, I'm going to subscribe.
All right, dear. All right. I'll see you next time. All right. Thank you.
You have reached your destination.
Hey, I'm Derek. How you doing?
Nicole.
Nice to meet you, Nicole. So, Nicole, tell me something good. What's going on with you today?
I'm on break right now from work, so.
Okay.
Get a helmet and hopefully get my moped today if the guy is willing to wait.
What kind of moped did you get?
It is a 2013
Dayang
VIP.
Oh, VIP. Girl, yeah. You know about the VIP status. Shoot, you don't get the good parking spaces. Is your first moped?
Yeah.
Yeah, you excited or nervous?
I'm a little bit of both, actually.
Okay.
Because I've never ridden one before. So.
Okay.
But, I mean, it can't be that hard.
No, it can't be. Now, for a moped, you don't have to have a motorcycle license, do you?
Actually, it depends on what speed you get.
So the one
I'm getting is a 50cc.
Okay.
So I don't need one.
Okay.
All right. I just need a driver's license or a learner's permit.
Okay.
The only thing is I can't get on highways with it.
Oh, okay.
Because it maxes out at like 40.
We could fix that.
Yeah. They actually have these things called bore kits that actually make it go faster.
Oh, yeah.
So I was like,
Bring it over to the house. We'll get you hooked up. You'll be doing 70 down on Milton Parkway.
They'll lift the speed up a little bit more.
Okay.
So like probably like 80. Once you get to like 125, 150 cc's, you have to have that license.
Okay. Yeah, it becomes more motorcycle territory than scooter territory. Mm-hmm. My best friend, so when he started off, so we was joking earlier, y'all, before we turned the camera on. Yeah, she's going to be buying a Hayabusa in like 3 weeks. But my best friend, so he bought a scooter for the very same reason. He was like, oh, man, he's like, D, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get this scooter, man, so I could ride back and forth to work. You know, gas was high. He had like an Escalade, and he's like, I'm tired of paying for this gas. He said, I'm going to get this scooter. I said, okay. So he comes by the house. We lived right around the corner from each other. This is when I lived in St. Louis. He come tooling around on the scooter. He's like, D, what you think? Yeah, I'm like, yeah, that's exactly what he did when he pulled up. So he pulls up, he got that. I said, okay, that's dope, man. So he's buzzing around the neighborhood. 2 weeks later, he come back. He got a new exhaust on it. I said, okay. He said, yeah, it's a little louder, man. Man, maybe 2 months, 3 months in, maybe a little bit longer, that dude came over, he had a motorcycle. He said, man, I had to upgrade. He had done so much to the moped that he couldn't do no more to it, and it wasn't going to go no faster. So, yeah, he went and got a bike.
Get a motorcycle.
Yeah, and he's still been upgrading ever since. Every time I talk to him, he's getting a new motorcycle because it's a bug. It's like a tattoo.
It is.
It's like a tattoo. You know,
my mom even said it because when I went to her and I was like, Mom, I know how you feel about bikes. how you feel. You want your child to be safe.
Yes.
But I can't do MARTA no more. I was like, I'm already getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, my God.
A 2-hour ride. And we live 17 minutes away.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Like, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
By highway, 17 minutes. I'm good.
Yeah.
Streetway, about 30 minutes.
You can do that.
I was like, I can't do it, Marta.
Yeah.
I'm too tired by the time I get to work. By the time I get home, it's time to go to bed.
All right, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to talk directly to this camera. Me and Nicole, we're going to talk directly to this camera. Listen, Marta. We're going to need y'all to extend the rail system, the train. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's number one. Y'all could take the train. I'm telling you right now, I'm going to be y'all next city planner, all right? Y'all could take the train from the North Spring Station, make a left turn, and go right out in the middle of Highway 400. And you can take it all the way to Cumming if you like, and just keep it in the middle of the highway, and just put little crosswalks over to the other side so that people can enter and exit without having to obstruct any traffic, without having to deal with tearing up anybody's yard or any of the above. Okay? Because folks tired of y'all, man. I saw a MARTA bus. I ain't gonna say where I was at when I saw this, but that MARTA bus ran a light that was so red. I was like, I don't even know how you didn't even notice that light was red. Like, it was like, where we are right now, red. And I'm sitting there and I can see him coming. I said, that dude ain't gonna stop. Man, that dude blew through that.
Hey, watch this. He about to go.
Yep. He blew through that signal. That was like dust and leaves. You know, when the car go past fast, all the debris on the side of the road.
He must have been
just
late.
Man, it's something. I say, shoot. I bet the passengers was in the back like, Lord, what I'm going to hold on to in this.
They probably like,
man. Yeah. Yes, as you can tell, I have a Sanford and Son ringtone on my cellular device. Yeah. I saw it went, so all right, so I decided that I wanted to try to find me like some old 70s sitcom ringtones. I can't find no originals. So I went and I looked for the one for Good Times. I don't know who they had singing for Good Times. It was the regurgitate. Keeping your head above water.
Oh, yeah.
Making a way when you can. Nicole, thank you so much.
All right,
enjoy your scooter. I'll see you on your high boost in about 3 weeks.
Yep.
I'll be looking for you. All right.
Speeding,
I know it's you. I'll be looking for that helmet. All right, take care.